If your Mac is running low on storage space, it can be pretty annoying sometimes, right? You know that you've got to free up some space, but you aren't really sure, well, what's taking up all of my space? How do I find out where all of my space is gone, right? So I want to show you a few different ways to, one, see how much space you have left, and then two, figure out precisely what's taking up the space so that you could delete stuff as intelligently as possible without deleting anything terribly important, hopefully. So let's dive in here and take a look. So the first thing here that we can do in macOS Ventura, and it's similar in other versions of macOS, is to open up system settings. Now, if I go to system settings and then in general, and then go to the storage option here, you'll see that at the very top of the screen, there is something that says macOS or Macintosh HD, and then there's this bar which represents my storage on my Mac here. So I've got a 1 terabyte SSD in my Mac, and I can see that I've got 784.95 gigabytes free, which is about what I would expect with my current usage. You know, I do some video editing on here, and some of the apps that I use are a little bit larger. Now, if I want to see what those apps are, which is a good question, then I can click on the eye icon next to this option here, this is applications, and I will get a listing of the apps that are installed on my Mac. So for example, I know that the install macOS Ventura app is about 12.58 gigabytes. So if I were to remove that, then that would free up some space for me for sure. Now, one gripe that I have with this interface is the fact that you'll see up here, there is something called system data, which is 46.26 gigabytes, right? And it is listed down here under system data, but what is that? I mean, where is it and how do I free it up? You know, some people have larger system data and some people have only a few gigabytes. So how do I make sure that I'm not using any more of that than I have to? For that, there are a few other apps that we can use and I'll show you what those are. Let's take a look. So this app here is called Disk Inventory X. And I like this app a lot because it's, well, one, completely free, and free is a great price, but it shows me in a visual way what is taking up all of my space on my Mac. So I can see, for example, that if I were to click on these two large boxes here, that the install macOS Ventura.app is about 12.6 gigabytes in size. So if I wanted to free up that space, then I could do that right here and know for a fact that those two are going to be the biggest, you know, space hogs on my system right now. So if I wanted to free up this macOS Ventura app, then I could go over here and right click on that and then reveal in Finder, and then drag that to my trash or use App Cleaner, which would be better, honestly. Or I could even right click on it and then move the trash right here, which is nice to be able to do that. This is a nice way to just see with your eyes what's taking up all of your space. Now, this does, of course, show you things like system data. Now, the application support folder, that would fall under what we would consider system data, or you know, the stuff here in system settings that we couldn't delete. So it didn't show me what those things are, right? So if I scroll down here and I know that system data was about 40 some gigabytes, well, it doesn't tell me what that stuff is, but I know that, for example, the application support folder is part of that. And if I can free up space out of that, then that would take that down as well. So that's kind of good to know. And Disk Inventory X is a great free app. I like it a lot. Check it out. This tool is called Disk Drill. And I covered Disk Drill in another video, you know, about some setup apps that I use. But this is a tool that is great for recovering data from your system. So if you've ever accidentally erased a file that you didn't really mean to lose, then the chances are this app might be able to recover it for you, which is kind of cool. But it does have a cleanup function here built in, which will do something similar to what Disk Inventory X will do, in that it will show me where my space has gone. Now, not visually, not in that nice graphical interface, but it does give me a listing of what's taking up my space. So for example, I know that my applications are again taking about 112.73, which is, you know, a reasonable amount of space. And if I do a drop down here, what's interesting is I can see that Xcode is actually taking about 23.89 gigs. So not just the 12 point whatever the other apps were showing me. So this is actually showing me a little bit more, which is interesting. And I know that if I were to remove this, then that would free up a bit of space for me. So this is nice to just kind of scroll through and see where my space has gone. Now, I do want to caution you here a little bit. Don't just go deleting stuff just because it says, you know, multiple gigabytes, because what you can do if you are getting a little delete happy is you can actually cause issues and delete some stuff that might be important. So just be careful there, okay? But this is a good way to get a good overview of what's taking up the space as well. So kind of nice. This app is called Clean My Mac X, and Clean My Mac X is a decent all-in-one optimization and cleaning tool. It's part of the Set App subscription. Now, I don't know that I would go buy this necessarily. I don't know that I would get Set App for this, because there are other tools out there and even free tools which will do much of the same stuff. You know, App Cleaner will uninstall applications for you, and Disk Inventory X will show you this visual picture of what's on your system. Onyx is a good optimization tool, but I do appreciate the app for what it is. And I like this the Space Lens feature here, which will show me a good picture of what's on my system. So for example, if I click on this applications folder, then I know that install macOS Ventura and Xcode are two of the biggest culprits on my system, right? They're two of the biggest applications that are on my computer currently. And if I were to remove those, then I would be freeing up, you know, a good chunk of space. So that's Clean My Mac X, which is a nice program. And overall, I like it a lot. Now, I do want to give you one little bit of a caveat before we wrap up here, is that as you use these tools, be very, very careful not to go through and delete stuff that you don't recognize. It's very tempting to see that, well, hey, this folder is taking up, you know, 9 gigabytes of space. I'm going to go ahead and remove it. Don't do that unless you absolutely are certain what it is, because what can happen is you can accidentally delete files that you really needed for certain programs, but you just didn't recognize, right? So a lot of things like in your library are important for preferences. You know, if you have certain settings and preferences saved with your applications, then that's where a lot of those preferences are going to be stored. So don't go through and delete stuff if you aren't certain, right? But these tools are good to just kind of give you a picture of what's on your machine and free up space as you can. So hopefully you like this video. Hopefully it's been helpful to you. If you have any questions, let me know down in the comments. And otherwise, like this video and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.